Welcome back to McCarthy Performance. We'll be modifying a big block Chevrolet oil pan. It's going into a Jeep and it doesn't fit, so we're got to do a little modification. Going to use a knockout punch, fine thread nut, shoulder down. It's going to sit in there, prep the area, going to punch it out. Probably going to clean it up just a little bit more right here. We want to get all this plating off of the oil pan. We don't want to try to weld through that, although I'm probably going to silicon bronze this on with the TIG. I don't want to put an excessive amount of heat on this. And it really doesn't need to be welded for the extra strength, and I'm probably going to do it that way. So this is going to punch a nice burr-free hole in the pan. If I can get it in there and slip it in there, it's got a little bit of a oil still in the pan. Built the engine for the customer, and then okayed the pan and realized that the pan that he okayed for fitment was not going to fit. Okay, so there's a clean, relatively burr-free hole there. Yep, nice and clean. Now we're gonna get it ready to weld. That'll fit on there like that. Probably move it like that just so it looks better. Probably gonna clean around this area a little bit more, then I'm going to reposition you, and then we're gonna fire up the TIG and do a little welding, and then the other side of the pan will be some severe modifications going on. So we're getting ready to silicon bronze that drain plug on the bottom of this pan. We'll start it right now. repositioned here. It's kind of tricky to do all this. Okay, that should be good for the drain plug, and now we're on the bigger and better things, I guess. Yeah, I don't like that. I'm gonna re-go over that. I'm gonna do a redo on that. Craters I want to fix. I'm going to hit them right now. Okay, we're gonna call that good. Should be nice and tight, shouldn't leak. Check it with some thinner when I'm done welding. You don't want to breathe that stuff. We got a little crater right there. You see that? We're going to hit that spot because I don't want any problems. Turn my post flow up just a little bit. Got it out of there. So that's one part of the pan that's done. Got her all TIG welded in. Silicon bronze, it's not really welding, but we'll call it welded for the day. Now we gotta cut this off. I don't know if I'm gonna put it on here. I might do that. Just save the aggravation of going up there and just whacking it off. Putting a plate of steel in there. I got a piece of steel. I'll probably pre-fit all that and be back on this video. Okay, we're back to cutting the pan. Now I'm cutting from the where he marked it, so if you look at it here, the pin isn't 100% square, and it probably isn't 100% square when they welded it, but that is the line that he marked, and that is, I restriked it. He agreed upon that, so we're going to zip it down here, and then we're going to take this part of the pan off and then put a plate on it, and I may silicon bronze it, or I may gas weld it, or TIG weld it, I'm sorry. It just depends on my mood that I'm in. Either way is more than adequate. Yeah. going to take probably longer to clean up the oil pan than it is to going to weld it all up and make sure that none of this crap is in here. Especially this kick up. That's one of the things I don't like about Morosos is that overlap. Good.
We'll be right back.